Good morning, everyone. I just wanted to take a minute before our Mass this Sunday to introduce our new associate. Father Erasto Nyoni joined us June 1st and will be with us at both St. Agnes and St. Kieran. Please, when the chances arrive, whether it's meetings or when we get back to Masses in the church, please know and welcome Father Erasto. Thank you.
Good morning, and welcome to the congregations of St. Agnes and St. Kieran's as we celebrate this Trinity Sunday. And before we begin, please take a moment of silence to prepare for the Eucharist.
Lord, have mercy. May we acknowledge this Trinity and adore your unity, powerful in all love and mercy. Pray this for our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. A reading from the book of Exodus. Early in the morning, Moses went up on Sinai, as the Lord had commanded him, taking the law and the two stone tablets. Having come down in a cloud, the Lord stood with Moses there and proclaimed his name, Lord. Thus the Lord passed before him, and cried out, the Lord, a merciful and gracious God, slow to anger and rich in kindness and fidelity. Moses at once bowed down to the ground in worship. Then he said, if I find favor with you, O Lord, do come along our company. This is indeed a stiff-necked people. Yet pardon our wickedness and sins, and receive us as your own. The word of the Lord. Thank you. so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Today we celebrate our faith in God as Trinity, God as community, and a relationship that cannot be separated. God has never alone and has promised that neither will we ever be. God's plan is for us to become a part of a community that is God. Seems that we live now in a time of crisis upon crisis upon crisis. From environment and climate to pandemic to painful economy to issues of violence and racism. Like Moses, we ask to see the face of God in all of this. And like God explains to him, we can only see the back of God, where God has been. And it is there that we see the identifying markers of God's presence and action in our world. We learn about God not from books, but from our dealings with people. The best we are in our choices with one another truly is something the face of the divine love knows. The memory of compassion, encouragement, commitment, forgiveness, and self-sacrifice that has touched us in our lifetimes are all godly qualities that we learn about in our living with others, and which ultimately reveal for us the very heart of God. Even our mistakes and failures as individuals, as a nation, and as a church, contain within the promise of God's abiding presence and the possibility of learning and beginning again. St. Paul says that God's love and mercy is with us as we mend our ways, encourage one another, and live in peace with one another. We have been able to change our behavior in response to the pandemic. We wear masks and stand aware of those around us and assume our shared responsibility for the common good. These past days have revealed for us that the virus of racism also lives within the air that we breathe. It infects our country in as active a way as COVID-19. We can change our behavior in the face of ingrained racism. We can listen to others as they tell their stories of fear and pain. We can educate ourselves on how institutions actually do work. We can stand in solidarity with those who experience the effects of violence and racial hatred. And we must change now and vote for those leaders who support that change. This feast of the Trinity should not be an abstract idea for any of us today, but rather see it as a gift that gets us to look and see and humbly be grateful for the mystery of God that is with us here and now, and in the better world that we promise to make happen by our openness to God's grace and love.
Let us
Pray that our sacrifice may be accepted, God the Father Almighty. Sanctified by the invocation of your name, O Lord our God, this oblation of our service, and by it make of us an eternal offering to you. We pray this in faith through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Similarly, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave him thanks, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." Keep us attentive to the needs of all, that sharing their grief and pain, their joy and hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. And also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may mount to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There in communion, blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, as Joseph, her spouse, apostles and martyrs, St. Agnes, St. Kieran, St. Paul, St. Irenaeus, and all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you, Jesus Christ, your Son. Thank you. receiving the sacrament of the Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul, as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity. Pray this to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Cardinal Servich has written me in a recent column of his in the Chicago Catholic. Columns entitled, A Time for National Reconciliation. In that article, he made reference to the Council of Catholic Bishops, who in a recent statement have said, we cannot turn a blind eye to these atrocities and yet still try to profess to respect every human life. We serve a God of love, mercy, and justice. As bishops, we unequivocally state that racism is a life issue. Cardinal Supich ended his talk with this paragraph. Tragedy does not eradicate hope. If there is anything we Christians take from our faith, it is that even the darkest deeds can be redeemed by love. And love is what is called for now. As Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. said, darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that. Not the law of transactional friendships and cheap associations made by the click of a mouse button or an easy retweet. Signpost solidarity will not do. Only the hard work of familial love will set us on the path toward justice. The love we read about in Scripture, the love God has for His children, every one of us, even when we fail, especially when we fail. Because God knows what His children are capable of, not only how we can fail in our humanity, but even more how we can build it up. So it is up to us to show God, to show all our brothers and sisters, the neighbors we know and the ones we will never meet, how deeply